Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Advait Kulkarni. I'm a senior consultant neurologist in Bangalore in my own clinic, HSR Neuro Clinic. And I'm a visiting consultant in Narayana Hospital in HSR layout and Manipal group of hospitals in Sarjapur Road. Three main types of migraine are migraine with aura, migraine without aura, and chronic migraine. A typical migraine is associated with episodic headache which lasts more than 4 hours with sensitivity to light, sound, or a tendency to vomit, and typically one cannot work during these episodes. This is a migraine without aura. Then what is migraine with aura? A few patients of migraine, maybe about 10% of patients, experience certain symptoms before the onset of migraine. Typically, the visual aura is most common, where in the one part of vision, patient cannot see, or there are some sparking lights, zigzag lines, or certain disturbances in the vision, which typically lasts for less than an hour, typically 10 to 15 minutes, following which a patient experiences a typical throbbing headache, which is severe enough to disturb one's daily activities. And the third one is the chronic migraine, where a patient experiences these episodes more than 15 days in a month for consecutively more than 3 months. And it is a very, very disabling condition. So the mainstay of treatment of migraine, along with the medicines which are given by your doctor, is lifestyle management. What is most important is having food when you are hungry. When you're hungry, you should not drink water, or you should not simply eat something light, because that will disturb your digestion and that might trigger migraine. When you're hungry, you have to eat something solid like rice or roti, and you should eat enough. If you eat less, that will also trigger migraine. Second important thing is you should not drink water unnecessarily. If you drink too much of water, that can also kill your hunger. And that can also trigger migraine, because all of us here that we have to drink 4 to 5 liters of water. But you have to be mindful about your thirst. You have to drink water as per your thirst and up to your thirst. You should not ignore your thirst. However, excess of water is also not needed. Third important thing is sleeping early in the night. If you sleep very late and wake up late, you are not following biological clock, and that will disturb your biological hormones, the sleep hormones. That is why sleeping early so that you feel fresh in the morning and completing your rest is most important. Being moderate in exercise. As you know, when you do over-exercise, when you feel too much tired after exercise, the migraines might get triggered by over-exercise. So being moderate in exercise, having your meals well when you're hungry, and sleeping early, and managing your stress by doing yoga, meditation, pranayama is very important. We strongly recommend a technique called anapana meditation, where you focus on your natural breathing. Medications, there are two types of medications. The first is the rescue drugs, which are the painkillers. Whenever the migraine attack is severe, one has to take these painkillers prescribed by doctors. And there are certain medications called preventive medications, which are given to patients who experience more than 4 to 5 episodes of headache, which are disabling in a month. And these medicines, your neurologist might ask you to take for 3 to 6 months or longer based on the attack frequency and severity. These preventive medications are said to be effective if they reduce the frequency of migraine by more than 50%. So understand that migraine is a cause and effect phenomenon. If you take care of the cause, you can eliminate the effect. That is the migraine. Thank you very much.